The name of this video is Maxwell. B. Local. Case 1. I remind you that case 1 means nothing but the differential form of matrix equations for the, in this case, magnetostatic field B. Let us consider, as always, a finite region of space, capital omega, bounded by a surface, capital sigma. We hypothesize that all these surfaces and regions are fixed with respect to given IRF inertial reference frame, as always. It's the easiest solution, easiest case. We also hypothesize that capital omega is a compact domain, and capital sigma is piecewise smooth. I remind you to look at video 19 for a more detailed description of these definitions here. We already used them in video 19 for the electrostatic field E. In addition, let us hypothesize that in this region of space, there is a current density vector J. This current is limited, that is, occupies a finite region of space within capital omega, and is also a steady current, or a DC current if you want. Eventually, we're going to extend it to the case of non-DC currents in physics 42. In addition, let's further hypothesize that J is a continuous function everywhere in capital omega all the way to the frontier capital sigma. Under these conditions, these are sufficient and necessary to show the differential form of Maxwell's equations for the magnetostatic field B. So let us consider, for example, the solenoidal property to begin with. We know that in integral form, the solenoidal property tells us that the surface integral on any closed surface capital sigma, like this one here, of B dot NDA has to be equal to zero. But before getting to that part, which is the physics part of this problem, let us use the divergence theorem, DT divergence theorem. So we know that we can compute this as the volume integral in the entire region capital omega, which has capital sigma as a boundary of the divergence of vector B, which is scalar, integrated over dB. And now the physics of the problem comes about. This has to be equal to zero. Because of the arbitrariness of capital sigma and capital omega, it follows that the divergence of B has to be equal to zero. And this is also true, for example, when J is equal to zero. So, summary here, we have that the divergence of B equal to zero. This is the differential form case one, local form case one, of the solenoidal property for B. What about the other law, which is Ampere's law? In this case, we know that the circulation along any closed line gamma contained within this region. Note that there were a few questions in this video, in a similar video 19. So we are doing, of course, the circulation on closed lines gamma within capital omega, or capital sigma if you want. So in this case, the circulation of B dot TDL, first of all, math before doing physics, we use the Stokes theorem. In this case, This allows us to rewrite this integral as the surface integral on an open surface capital sigma gamma, where sigma gamma has this line gamma as a border. Remember, the hat used to go for skiing is that kind of construction. And so this becomes the curl of B, so then dA. The flux of the curl of B is my new vector field. And now the physics of the problem. So math is done, and I'll take care of the physics, which tells us that this has to be equal to mu naught times the current I linked. This is current linked with this line gamma. Now, since we are using a DC current, let's impose this condition that the current is DC, so a steady current. In that case, so this can be rewritten as mu naught. Well, we know that the current intensity I is nothing but the flux through N, in this case, the surface, open surface, capital sigma gamma, which has small gamma as a border, of J dot NDA, the flux of J. It's only true, of course, in steady conditions. So now we have math physics and more physics, which is the condition of being steady DC currents. So now, because of the arbitrariness of all these structures here, this simply implies that the integrand have to be equal to each other, which means, as a consequence, that the curl of B has to be equal to mu naught J, which is the differential form, that is local form case one for the magnetostatic field B, Ampere's law. We will actually summarize all this in a table at the end, comparing to the electrostatic field case. So these are Maxwell's equations in differential form case one for the magnetostatic field B. Now, there is one thing which is worth mentioning one more time here, is that the only thing I hypothesized is that J is continuous everywhere in the space considered here, in the universe considering this problem. To be more precise, one should also impose that B is continuously derivable in the same region of space. Because obviously, in order to be able to compute the gradient and divergence of B, B has to be a continuously derivable function in a vector sense, as a matter of fact. Now, when people say that the integral form is the same as the differential form, they are obviously absolutely 100% wrong, because this is true only under all these conditions. As I did in videos 1920, etc., many videos ago, I conjectured that it's actually enough to have a continuous current density, in this case J, and in the case of the electric field was a rho, which was supposed to be continuous, the current charge density, for being able to break down this differential form. This is a conjecture. Actually, you really want also B, but the reason why B is bad to impose this condition is because nature gives us J, it doesn't give us rho, it gives us a current which generates a field. So it's a conjecture, but it's a reasonable one, as it turns out. And so under these conditions, you can state this differential form. But it is not true that they are equivalent to the integral form. The integral form is always the most general form. The differential form is a subcase, if you want, of the integral form, okay? And then eventually we need to study case two, which is what is coming up in the next video. So to summarize, here we wrote down case one. So case one is what I call the differential form for the magnetostatic field Maxwell's equations. So another property, divergence of B equal to zero, and Ampere's law, which is the curl of B equal mu naught J only in the case of DC current, with this conjecture in mind. That's it.